Al-Imam Abi Dawood, he narrated in his Sunan min hadithi Jabir radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, that Jabir radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, one day we were a traveler, me and a group of people. A man from amongst us got wounded, and at night he had a wet dream. And so when he woke up, he said to the people, can any one of you find for me a ruling in the Quran or the Sunnah that allows me to not use water because I'm wounded? And they said to him, no. If there is water, you have to use the water. So what the man did was, he used the water and then he died from it. When the companions came to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to them, قَتَلُوهُ قَتَلَهُمُ اللَّهُ. They killed this man, may Allah kill them. Look what the Prophet then said, أَلَا سَأَلُوا إِذْ لَمْ يَعْلَمُوا. Why did they not ask when they didn't know? إِنَّمَا شِفَاءُ الْعِيِّ السُّؤَالِ فَإِنَّمَا شِفَاءُ الْعِيِّ السُّؤَالِ. The cure to ignorance is by asking and gaining knowledge. The Messenger referred to ignorance as an illness and that it needs cure. What is the cure? The cure is to gain knowledge. The Prophet ﷺ, he told us of the story of the man who killed 99 people. And then when he killed 99 people, this man wanted to repent. And so he asked for a person of knowledge. And the people, they said to him, go to a monk. فَدُلَّ عَلَىٰ رَاهِبٍ. So they told him to go to a monk. A monk is a worshipper. He doesn't have no knowledge. So when the killer came to the monk, he said to him, I did this. I want repentance. He said to him, Allah will never repent for you, or never will He accept your sins. 99 people you've killed, Allah will never accept your sins. فَكَمَّلَ بِهِ الْمِئَةِ. He took his sword out and he killed this man. And he made it 100 people. This man's verdict, based on ignorance, made him die from it. It was the consequences of him dying. So ignorance makes you kill somebody, and ignorance also makes you kill yourself.